The Jernegan family has a special history in Mishawaka, and it's nice that it's preserved.
The story of how well the Jernegan family history is preserved at the downtown Mishawaka Library is evident before even entering the Heritage Room. The stained glass windows with intricate colored glass design, mounted high above the doors, were once mounted in the Jernegan family home.
The library parking lot actually is located where Edward Jernegan's home was. My name is Richard Jernegan Doolittle. I am one of the founders of Cressy Commercial Company in Mishawaka. My great-grandfather was Edward Jernegan, who was the proprietor of the Mishawaka Enterprise for a number of years. But he was a postmaster here in Mishawaka, as well as the proprietor and publisher of the Mishawaka Enterprise. Through early 20s, when he passed away, and my grandfather, Ralph, assumed ownership for a period of time, which ultimately became my Uncle Paul's office and apartment building, and directly to the south of that building was my grandfather, Ralph Jernegan, and Estella's home. So the two houses together are integral parts of the redevelopment and modernization of the Mishawaka Public Library. At the time of the gifting of those properties to the library, it immediately became a feature of the library, and it's nice that it's continued. I never really knew Edward Jernegan, only stories about him that I learned through my family.
Edward would have been my great, great grandfather, whom I never met. I am in the IT support business, very much not the family norm. We keep businesses up and running and out of harm's way. My middle name is Hartwell, Drew Eric Hartwell Johnson. Hartwell is a middle name of my grandfather's. Ralph Hartwell Jernegan, and it's a way to, if you will, pass on the lineage and the history and take pride in where your family came from.
Drew, he doesn't like to admit it, but he's my nephew.
My uncle Rick also shares a middle name, Jernegan. My uncle's middle name is important to him as it was his mother's maiden name.
Edward was my great-grandfather, and his son Ralph Jernegan was my grandfather, who was an attorney, Indiana legislator. He and his wife Estella gave birth to three children. He was principally a lawyer in Mishawaka and wasn't capable of doing two jobs, so he decided to dispose of the Mishawaka Enterprise. My grandfather was an Eagle Scout and a very active participant in the scouting movement in St. Joseph County, and was responsible in part for the acquisition and creation of the Res, which was is a little camping area on the east side of Mishawaka. And he donated the money necessary to create the lodge that is on that park, and it's called Jernegan Lodge. And Paul Frank Jernegan, architect, was quite a personality and an incredibly creative man. He had no boundaries, was very, very successful in doing the work that he did. Things that stand out about his career that we can point to with great honor is that he was the architect that put the additions on Mishawaka High School. If you look at Mishawaka High School, you couldn't tell one part of the school from the original part. It's a beautiful job.
So my uncle Paul, he too had offices in Goshen and Chicago. While in Chicago, he became friends with Frank Lloyd Wright, which was obviously a very well-known architect at the time, and one that he very much looked up to, had a lot of respect for, and had a mutual friendship with him.
Interestingly, the vision of my Uncle Paul, the bringing in of Chicago-styled retail into the downtown core of Mishawaka, major office location into the downtown core. The city fathers didn't find that there's much credibility to the plan, but interestingly, much of what his vision was actually came to fruition in a little different form. Liberty Mutual, 100,000 square foot major company, created a headquarters in downtown Mishawaka. Every major retailer that was anybody, from Penny's to Sears and Roebuck to Macy's, located in Mishawaka. Everything that he had in his vision for downtown Mishawaka actually came to fruition in Mishawaka, just not quite in the vision that he saw, except I don't think we have a tower, a residential tower.
My memory of Paul, it was that of an architect, very eccentric, very much in love with the city of Mishawaka. I remember Christmas dinners at their house. He lived a very humble life, a very proud person. He did not have any children, and I have two sisters. I think he felt very much like we were a part of his family, and therefore were invited over for many dinners in that regard. And over the course of time, been that guy that is tapped on the shoulder and is asked, would you like to keep this as part of the family name and history and the nostalgic memories that it brings to the table? And therefore, I've ended up with some variety of items, from furniture to desks to a car. This was a desk that he personalized for an octagon or turret style room. He, of course, designed it. I do know the marble top came from Italy. He had great pride in the detail of the desk and the functionality. There was even three buttons on the side here that were used for who knows what. He was kind of like me in some respects, in that he was much more of a pack rat of family history, and for that a great deal of, I think, gratitude and thankfulness on the family's behalf goes out to him for saving everything under the sun,
including hand-drawn Christmas cards he sent out each year.
But this one he made, I think, for a studios of Paul Frank Jernegan. But I just think this is epic. I keep it out year-round now as a result of it. Just love it.
A copy of the Christmas card can be found inside the Jernegan bookcase, right below the silhouetted sign that once stood as a local landmark outside Paul Jernegan's architectural office.
Everything that was important to the betterment of the community as a whole was a principal obligation of the Jernegan family.
I think it's a great honor being a descendant of that family. I too am very proud and loyal to the city of Mishawaka. I do believe that there are a lot of other families that share that same sentiment.